everyone in the audience, and I request everyone on the front row to be seated. People here will be able to see him a lot better, the authors, the panelists, everyone, if they step a little further behind. Ladies and gentlemen, we're extremely sorry for the delay. We gathered here today for the launch of Teenage Blues, Parenting Blues by Anjaneya Mishra, the author.
Good evening, everyone. I'd just like to say a few words about our guests on stage here. The leading Bollywood actor on stage needs no introduction, but in the context of our book, it is worth mentioning that he is the son of legendary star Amitabh Bachchan and captivating actress Jaya Bhaduri. Abhishek himself has received 3 Filmfare Awards for acting and a national award as producer for Pa, where he played a father to his own father, Amitabh Bachchan. He is now the proud parent of a beautiful baby, Aradhya, who was born on 16th November 2011. In one of the interviews on Abhishek, Amitabh stated that I look upon Abhishek as another father and son relationship, where he is more a friend of mine than a son.
Good evening, everyone, and my apologies for being late. बैठ जाइए भैया नहीं तो चला लेंगे वो लोग ठीक है अभी apologies for being late. There was some serious traffic on the way from Juhu. I live in Juhu, which is a good 1 hour away, so my apologies for being late. Thank you very much for having me here, and may I start off by congratulating Anjaneya on this wonderful book. And what's amazing is to see somebody with such age on his side and wisdom on his side to write a book like this. We usually, you know, lean back on people of experience and age to teach us about life. I think it's so refreshing that today's generation doesn't really necessarily believe in that. They have an opinion, they have a point of view, and thanks to Joico and Crosswords, they now have an avenue through which they can express that. And well, how has it been being? Thankfully, I don't think my father ever needed to subscribe to Anjaneya or to ask him for help. I hope he doesn't have that opportunity anymore. And I sincerely hope that I never need to read his book and get tips. But now that I know the author personally, I can always give him a call if I need any tips. But thankfully, Aradhya is very small. She's not a teenager yet, thank God. So none of those problems, but I'm sure there are a lot of people out there who will love to read this book and learn from it. I think the perspective with which it's written is fantastic. I've never heard of a book being written about teenagers by somebody who started writing this book when he was in 10th standard, as he just told me. And it's truly sensational, and I really, really hope that people do take a lot back from it. His mother didn't seem to have any complaints, so I guess the book works. And I wish you all the very best. Thank you for being here. And I think we'll pass it on to him now.
We'll get to Anjaneya later, but Abhishek, Aradhya is going to get there someday, so you must pick up a couple of these copies right on.
Oh, thankfully, he's already given me a signed copy, so I have one, yeah.
Mishani, we'd love to proceed to you. Before that, Anjaneya, I must give you a hats off to have the principal of your own college out here. It's a perfect way to make sure that none of those KTs or anything really hold any true later.
Actually, any hope I had of escaping her questioning is now gone, because she's already asked me how many times have I attended college this year.
Were you satisfied with the answer, Mishani?
And I asked him who his economics professor was. And he didn't know the answer. I just want to know if it was a man or a woman who teaches economics. Okay, so let's go. All right, I have to say something here. When Anjaneya came into my room with his mother and said he had written this book, and he had written this book on parenting, and I said the first thing I asked him was, how did he write it? And of course, he's going to tell you more about it, but he said his friends used to find a lot of problems, which means I must compliment the mother. He didn't find the problems, it was his friends, and then he, through that experience. But you know, when I was going through the book, and I read all of it last night, and very reader-friendly, Jayco, very well done, congratulations. When I was reading it, there was something that was, you know, hitting me. When I was 16, I thought my mother was there to make my life miserable because she was telling me to do things I didn't want to do, right? Like your mother told you to clean the room today, even at 37, right? When my son was 16, right, I thought he was there to make my life miserable because he was not doing the things that I was telling him to do. So I think I have been caught in that generation where I am at the receiving end both from my mother and from my son. Because I think the generation that we are parenting is an amazing generation. And I can just tell you that Abhishek, you're going to enjoy every minute of the day in parenting that. And there are a lot of things that he has written in, and I'm sure we're going to bring these things out. But I think the most important thing, and I read Penelope Leach, because I had my baby in London, and I read Penelope Leach, and she just said that one sentence, which she said, give everything to your baby, unconditional love, and everything falls right. And it does at the end of the day. So I think he's understood that very young in life, and that adage that the child is the father of man, you proved it. You have actually given lessons to your mother on how she should parent you. So I think that's very smart, and he's done a wonderful job, and I congratulate him. And let me tell you, those who are not even parents now, please pick up the book, because when your kids come out in this technology savvy world, God help you.
I apologize to everyone else in the audience. This is just going to take one more minute. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, engineer. This is a proud moment for someone who's just 19 years old, guys. We can afford to have a bigger round of applause for him. Come on. Engineer, I'd love to get to you to know your experiences with the book. What made you write this? And if possible, to even read some extracts for us later on.
One thing probably nobody thought of while writing a book on parenting is how exactly do you go to your mother and say, okay, here, this is how you should parent me. I'm thankful to God that that didn't backfire on me, because I probably wouldn't be here today if you had. Good evening, Indushani ma'am, Mr. Bachchan, family and my friends. It's a great honor for me to share this stage with such illustrious people as I present my book. The weeks of nausea and fear at the thought of giving this address led me to dive into my often neglected textbooks. Ma'am, you would have good reason to believe that I will do quite well in my ongoing boards this year. This book started out as a thought that came to me when I saw the lives of my friends change as they entered high school. The curiosity it sparked in me led me to explore our lives and why this had happened. My friends were rather suspicious as I poked around unceremoniously in their lives, but they thankfully never caught on. I tried my best to casually deflect their questions and continued to prod, much to their annoyance. This was my secret pet project, which no one really knew about. And believe me, I paid the price for my secrecy. Trying to get 1,000 suspicious and annoyed teenagers to fill out a painfully personal survey without letting them know what I was up to has been single-handedly one of the biggest challenges of my life. It was probably best that they didn't treat it then, for they would have surely disowned me, and there would have ended my project. My family has unfailingly been behind me in this entire journey, and I would like to thank them for showing restraint when they must have felt like shooting me. Before I read the passages from my book, I would like to thank Mr. Bachchan once again for taking time out from his extremely hectic schedule and being here with us today. So, it is very encouraging to me that you have been with us today. I am deeply obliged. The fond memory of today will remain with me forever. Ma'am, you are my mentor and guide and a big inspiration to all of us in college. I look forward to your continued support and guidance in my endeavors. Thank you.
Anjaneya, thank you. This is not a part of the script, but I think it's also interesting to ask your parent what she thinks of her kid writing a book on parenting. It'll be interesting to just know from your mom her thoughts on what she thinks on the book and on you as an author. Being his friends and all that. But I think if you look at the first line in the book, it says, for any child, the first source of advice is usually the parents. The child doesn't know anyone else, he has no idea of the world, and is naturally gullible. So, I think somewhere I might have been some inspiration to him, good or bad, we don't know. But one thing I want. So I think that goes for every parent, actually, for all the parents who are here and for all the teenagers who are here. I'm sure they acknowledge that to their parents, and all the parents know what a great responsibility they have. So thank you for all being here, and thank you, Mr. Bachchan and Mrs. Sani.
Anjaneya, we would love for you to read out some extracts from the book if that's possible.
As Mr. Akash had said earlier, this is something related to what he had talked about being friends with your teenager. Now I'm going to start. Once you become your teen's friend, don't assume or expect that they will tell you everything. In fact, many a parent must have witnessed how defensively teens react to the mere perception of privacy invasion, even when there is really nothing to hide at all. The first tenet is that there are always secrets. Now, if you think that by exerting pressure or adopting a honeyed approach, that is by playing the occasional good cop, bad cop routine, you can get something out of your 16-year-old, I would really hate to be in your position. I can bet you'll tear your hair in despair and only end up ensuring that your teenager insists that his parents don't even try to understand him. Now, I would like to ask you, how much truth is there to what your father says about you being his friend?
A lot, actually. I started wearing my father's shoes when I was about 11, I remember. And since then, he's always been somebody who's been a buddy, you know. His idea of parenting was, and he said this to me at a very young age, is that I'll never hide anything from you. I will incorporate you in all my decisions, and I will always ask you your opinion. Your job is to make sure that your opinion is something I can listen to. And he always treated me as an equal, although we all knew we weren't his equals, but his behavior towards us, towards my sister and I, was always the same, and especially with me. I think, as everybody knows, fathers and daughters have a very special bond, and mothers and sons have a very special bond. So for my father, my sister is obviously the apple of his eye, but I was always his friend, and that's something I hope I can incorporate, you know, with Aradhya. And I think it has many benefits. Obviously, there's very less room for secrecy, as you just said.
Yeah.
When your parent is approachable, a great example for me is actually my sister. I have an elder sister. And my niece, who's like my daughter, is 16. And I see the relationship that they have. And it's one of friends. And I think that's something that really helps break down the barriers between parents and teenagers.
So how successful were you at your job of telling him what you wanted? Or would you just tell him what you wanted and, you know, hope that he would just do it?
No, it was never that easy. I mean, things had to be earned. It was never that easy that I'd just say that this is what I think and this is what I feel and it'd be done. You had to convince him. There was always, healthy debate was always encouraged in our house. So whether it was the most small matters or something which was of great import, the whole family has always sat down and discussed things at an open forum. And us, as when we were children, were always given to believe that our opinion had as much weight as anybody else's.
All right. Thank you so much. Now I move on to my next section. Life is not a piece of cake or a bed of roses. I simply have to raise my head and look around, and the rough and tumble roller coaster of life hits me hard in the face. Take my dad, for instance. I have rarely seen him return home from work before 9 p.m., utterly tired and pretty much exhausted, despite his plush air-conditioned office. My cousin, albeit young and energetic, is sometimes seen working in his office till 3 a.m., as if tomorrow simply just does not exist. What are they all working for? Is it survival or is it security? It seems crystal clear to me now that you don't have to work hard enough. If you don't work hard enough, you don't get anything or go anywhere. It's just that simple. When you develop your child's ability to struggle, you're preparing him for success. And once your teen stops expecting things to just drop into his lap, he will learn to work. Teens, let's stop kidding ourselves. Take a look around. The world is very difficult, very fast-paced. It's not exactly a valley of flowers, it's a bloody battlefield. There are people out there who have to fight tooth and nail for their survival, and do I even need to remind you of Darwin's postulate of the survival of the fittest? Now, the battle is in the boardroom, and it's not just your education that'll pay off. I would say it's more your grit and tenacity. The sooner we realize it, the better it is for us. This brings me to the time that I went to ma'am with the invitation for the book, and she was just leaving for a meeting for the Colgate board. Ma'am, what do you think? What do you think will matter in the coming years when people will actually be reading this book and trying to parent their difficult teenagers?
I think it'll be very, very helpful, but I must say, this is almost like an exam for us. I was just telling Abhishek, he reads the book and he asks us a question. Okay, but I hope we are successfully answering all your questions. You know, I just want to take you off on a couple of other tangents. First of all, you've said over there for a 16-year-old, he must struggle, and if he doesn't work hard, he's not going to get anywhere and so on. You know, something that worked with my 16-year-old was tell him exactly the opposite of what you want him to do.
Thank you.
Okay, so my question is, what was that incident, or was there any moment which inspired you for writing this book? What actually inspired you for writing this book?
Actually, I don't think there was one defining moment, like a linchpin, that just propelled me to write this book. It was more a series of events. I would go to school and I would see one kid just sitting in the corner, like looking furious with life. And it was morning and we hadn't even had a morning assembly. I could understand that he would have had to get up in the morning, but that wasn't a reason to be furious. So I went and I asked him, what happened? And then, you know, the disturbing stories that I used to hear just made me think that, why is this even happening? So there was a parent who made his child into a murga, squat down and hold his ears, just because he called his mother Yar by mistake. And that's just one thing I got to hear. There are many others like that. So, you know, these things just make you think and make you wonder that, why is this even happening in households? Like, it's not that the parents don't like their children. Obviously, they do. But they're treating them so badly. So, that's what.
Anjaneya,
I think you need to put it on.
Moment of sitting over here and speaking to people and having your book opened, and I think you're very fortunate to be part of JECO, and Akash and everybody is a wonderful team.
Yeah, excellent team.
That being said, I wanted to ask you, what professional studies do you plan to pursue?
Okay, that was a very difficult question again.
Sorry, maybe you don't want me to ask, it's okay.
So, initially in fact, we can relate that to the conversation we had in ma'am's room the other day. So, I'm done, I was planning to do CA, and but I felt it was too boring, but ma'am is encouraging me to stick with it and complete it, and let's see, I've not planned anything out yet.
Well, we look forward to more books from you also, other than what you've written wonderfully.
Yeah, definitely, definitely.
And it's an achievement in itself. I think to write a book first at your age, studies and everything, and the blues that go along with it, and being a part of JECO's team. So I think it's a double victory.
Thank you.
Really, all the best and congratulations, really.
All right. Thank you so much.
अभिषेक, आपसे मेरा एक सवाल है. जब आप खुद टीनेजर थे तो आपके मन में कौन से फियर्स थे? क्या आप भी ऐसे कुछ बुक लिखने का सोच रहे थे, या ऐसी कौन सी अलग जो क्रिएटिविटी आपके माइंड में थी, या कौन से ऐसे फियर्स थे एज अ टीनेजर?
सलमा, यू मेक इट आउट टू बी लाइक आई वाज अ टीनेजर सम 30 डेकेड्स अगो. आई एम नॉट दैट ओल्ड.
नो,
या देयर वाज नथिंग लाइक दैट एक्चुअली. आई हैव जस्ट बीन थिंकिंग ऑन द स्टेज about what I used to think as a teenager, and I think I was very blessed that I had a very carefree childhood. I was in boarding school, so, you know, my life revolved around dramatics and sports and a little bit of going to class as well. And although we couldn't cut class in boarding school, because, I mean, where would you go? But, you know, I never ever had these moments of disagreement with my parents, thankfully. And I give entire credit of that to my parents, I guess. And like ma'am, you were saying, you know, at the end of the day, I think it's the children who teach the parents, and they should be the teachers. I witness it every day with my daughter, how she teaches both Aishwarya and I to be parents. And I'd like to believe that my sister and I set some sort of an example to our parents of how they needed to conduct themselves around us. But I never had any moments where I was compelled to write a book, thankfully. Although I don't think JECO would have published my book. I don't have half the talent in writing that young Anjaneya has. And I think it's best that he wrote the book and not me.
As you said that rose day by day kuch na kuch aradhya se seekh rahe hain. What was the one thing jo ab tak 2 saal mein kuch seekhi ho as a parent?
I think unconditional love is the first thing that any parent should learn. There's nothing more precious than a young newborn life in your lives, and it's a gift, and it's something that needs to be treasured and loved. And unconditional love is something which will just literally set everything free, and it opens so many doors. It makes you realize so much about yourself as a human being, not only as a parent. But I think what children require the most, and I'm sure any teenagers here, is that, you know, if you just give them a bit of compassion, a bit of understanding, and a bit of space, like ma'am was saying, you don't need to teach them anymore. They have everything at the click of a button. You have to be sensitized to their wants, and you have to sensitize them to the rest of the world. And I think that's very important.
Thank you. We have time for just one last question. Sorry.
Abhishek, what's your biggest fear when Aradhya becomes a teenager? What's your biggest fear as a father?
There's several. How much time do you have? I think as if you ask any new parent, they'll tell you the same thing. You know, we live in times where there's so much we can worry ourselves of. And there's so much we can worry ourselves with. But I think the thing I'm most scared about is that I don't want to feel guilty in any which way. And I hope... you know, we thanks to you all, the media, we get to hear some rather ghastly stories. But I hope every parent on earth thinks like this. I really hope that my child will feel that my parents have done whatever they could for me in terms of emotionally, physically, monetarily, whatever it may be. But most importantly, emotionally, I think, you know, your child must always respect what all sacrifices their parents also put through. I know we're here discussing teenage blues, but I'm sure if you ask Anjaneya's mother, she'll tell you of all the things she's had to do to be able to just understand what her son wants to do. It's a huge task for a parent also to understand what a child is going through. And I just hope that my daughter, when she's a teenager, turns out to just appreciates what all her mother and her father have done or continue to do, as I, till date, as a 37-year-old, respect, acknowledge and love my parents for all that they continue to do for me today as well.
Abhishek, as we know very clearly that, you know, Aishwarya Rai Bachchan's birthday is coming very soon. What are your big plans for this day, and how do you plan to celebrate it? Obviously, now she's mother as well.
And what birthday gift will be on your side?
Haan ji?
What birthday gift will be on your side?
Ye kitab.
Right. How did I just know that question was going to come up? Yes, it's her birthday in a few days. And we hope to celebrate it. And yes, I hope I can find a gift in time. And I hope she likes it. How? I mean, you want to come cover it or something? I mean, if I tell you, you might be hanging off a window somewhere trying to take a photograph. But no, very honestly, we haven't planned anything right now. I've just returned this morning from Bangkok. I was shooting in Bangkok. I've just returned, so I have to start planning and do something. It's her birthday. And she's expressed her desire to spend it with the family and her near and dear ones. So we'll try and organize something.
Thank you. Anjaneya, to wrap up, we'd like to ask one last question to you.
Can I ask a question?
Okay.
So Abhishek...
What are your plans for your birthday next year?
So what is the one incident from your teenage that you wish your parents would have handled a little differently?
Wow. Not much, actually, you know, because I as a teenager, I never really went to them with my problems. The school I was in always taught us that, you know, if you have a problem, you should sort it out for yourself. And I think that's kind of the point, a certain point of boarding school as well, that, you know, you're not protected by your parents all the time. So you have to find a solution to your own problems. And you learn independence in that manner. What would I have hoped? My gosh, I'd have to really think. But I have no complaints. They've been exemplary parents. So I have no complaints. But now that you set me off on this track, I'm sure there's going to be a list of complaints I'm going to come out with tonight on the dinner table.
I think we can really do with one right now.
Yeah. I think my parents have had it tonight. Why didn't you do this for me as a kid? No, they've been brilliant parents. I seriously cannot think of even one thing I would have wished they handled differently. And I think the reason for that is because in whatever they did or have to handle for me, I was very much a part of it and made a part of it. And I think that's a good tip for a parent. You know, inculcate and... you know, make your children a part of solving their problems as well. Let them get a bit of ownership and responsibility.
I think that's very similar to what I've said in the book.
So I'll make a good parent?
Yeah, okay. I think...
I'm relieved now.
Thank you, Anjaneya.
I think just one sec. He said in the book that 57% of the young young people who interviewed said that they like the way their parents are parenting them, and they like their parents to have a say in what they should do, which is a great thing, because whenever I used to ask students, why aren't you attending, they'd say, because we are not made to. Right? So that's what it is. Parents, don't stop parenting. One thing before you end, to you, and that's a command from the principal of your college.
You
better report 7 a.m. lecture, but before that, I want Anjaneya to write a book, same book, at the age of 49.
Ah, yes. That would be fun.
Thank you, everyone.
After
kids and after having a 19-year-old, I'd like to see how you're writing now.
So that's when the sequel is going to come out.
Yeah. Marketing alert. I think we're going to take this later.
I'm going to meet you all in a couple of hours at the Palladium Hotel. I'll do it then. You'll get a nice close-up. You can light me nicely.
Let's respect the author and the fact that we're here today for the book launch.
Yeah. Let's wish Anjaneya a very happy Diwali. Yeah.
That's a good
thank you, everyone, for being here with us today. Copies of the book are available at the cash counter.